Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our October program. This fall, we are proud to present a series of programs featuring our teacher advisors. They are our role models who inspire us with their knowledge and increase our appreciation of Ikebana. Last month, we saw Mrs. Kayoko Fujimoto, who taught us so much about traditional Ohara arrangements. Today, we will see Mrs. Joan Suzuki and her inspiring Sogetsu arrangements. Today, I also want to welcome Mrs. Kaori Higuchi and Ms. Yumiko Ishii from the Japanese Consulate, who are watching this program along with us. Now, I would like to introduce our chairman of the day, Ron Brown.
Thank you, Sharon. Before I introduce our demonstrator, Joan Yasui Suzuki, I would like our exhibitors to introduce themselves and give a brief explanation of their arrangements.
Hello, good afternoon. My name is Echo Choke and I'm with Sugetsu School of Ikebana. My teacher is Jane Naito and Joan Suzuki. For today's arrangement, I made a fall arrangement using Chinese pistachio with the berries, and for color, I added coxcomb and ornamental eggplants. And the branch is a plum branch that I've been saving for the right moment. And here it is. Thank you very much for the opportunity, and I hope you enjoy Suzuki Sensei's demonstration today. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Jane Naito. My sensei is Joan Suzuki, today's demonstrator. When I think of autumn, I think of my favorite fruit, persimmons, kaki in Japanese. For today's side arrangement, I'm using a container by Thomas Arakawa, along with some bird of paradise flowers and some maru persimmons that I cut from my garden just this morning. I've also included some bear grass and some beautiful yellow cymbidiums. I hope you like my arrangement. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Tang Nguyen and I study Sogetsu Ikebana under Joan Suzuki Sensei. Today I have this arrangement, a fall arrangement, and I'm using pretty much fall materials. So my main branch here is a Chinese pistache with a lot of berries on it. And also I cut this butternut squash from my garden this morning and it'll be ready for dinner tonight. Other kinds of material is this kind of succulent, and it looks like fingers. Very nice for Halloween arrangement. And also I have gerber daisy, which is a new variety that looks pretty much like a spider mum instead of a gerber daisy. And the container is from Bruno. It's a modern container. It has two sizes of opening. And I prefer to use this to show off all the material I'm using today. Thank you so much. And I hope you enjoy the program today.
Hello, everyone, and happy autumn. I'm very honored to be here today. My name is Sandra Hatcher, and I study Ikenobo Ikebana. And I'm very happy to study with my sensei, Miyako Tageta. Today's demonstration is titled Autumn Breeze. And I don't know about you, but this week in Sacramento, there was a tremendous autumn breeze. So I've tried to arrange to reflect that today. I have arranged a classical Rika style called Rika Shofutai. And my main materials are bittersweet, pampas grass, iris leaves, hydrangea, fall burnet, some dried driftwood, chrysanthemum, and spindle tree. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Mitsuko Maruyama of Ohara Ikebana School. My teacher is Mrs. Suyo Fujimoto. I'm so honored to be asked to put arrangement in today. Today's style, I put bunjin, using miniature pomegranate, lotus leaf and pod, and lily. I hope you all enjoy. Thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Susan Okada, and my arrangement to, I belong to the Wafu School of Ikebana. My sensei is Mrs. Fusako Hoira. My arrangement today is an upright Moribana style, and I've chosen purple millet, grevillea, chrysanthemums, and solidago. And in honor of the upcoming Halloween, I've included a ceramic pumpkin with driftwood. I hope you enjoy the arrangement. Thank you.
I want to thank you all for your wonderful arrangements. Joan Yusui Suzuki was born in San Francisco and moved to Japan at age 6. While in Japan, she began her studies of Sogetsu Ikebana, receiving her first teaching certificate at the age of 16. Returning to the US in 1949, she continued her college studies, graduating from San Francisco City College. In 1953, she began teaching Ikebana classes while assisting her mother, Shun-ei Uchida, in her classes. It was Mrs. Uchida who introduced Sogetsu Ikebana to the Bay Area. In 1973, Joan was awarded the rank of Riji, the highest rank in our school, by Headmaster Sofu Teshigahara. Joan Sensei joined II as a member at large prior to the founding of our chapter and is a charter member of our chapter. She is also the Sogetsu school advisor for us. Joan is a founding member of the San Francisco Bay Area branch of the Sogetsu School, has served as deputy director, director, and currently as director emeritus. She is a charter member and former president of the Ikebana Teachers Federation. Joan has participated in and demonstrated at many of the programs and flower shows for these three organizations. Sensei has received many awards for her Ikebana and cultural activities throughout her career. Most recently, she received the Certificate of Commendation from Consul General Yamada for promoting relations between California and Japan through Ikebana. She was inducted into the Bunka Hall of Fame from the JAANC and received the Overseas Honor Award at the 90th Sogetsu Commemorative Ceremony in Tokyo. For those of us who have been blessed to know Joan, we know her two great passions in life are her family and her love of Ikebana. Her students and we, her Ikebana friends, are her second family. It is now my privilege to introduce to you Joan Yusui Suzuki.
Good afternoon. Thank you, Ron. I'm very happy to demonstrate this afternoon for theme Autumn Breeze. I hope you will enjoy it. My first arrangement is going to be Aki no Nanakusa.
Joan, what is that branch that you are currently holding?
Yamagobo, in Japanese, pork weed in English. And in there are many different types of mazeike, mixed arrangement, but autumn, 7 glasses of autumn arrangement is a very common, famous type. And I don't think I can find the 7 typical material which we use in Japan, but I try to collect as much as possible, similar to Aki no Nanakusa, Japanese 7 glasses.
The basket that you're using, is that a traditional basket?
It's a very common basket, which olden days farmers used for tossing the grains to separate from the outside of the grain, and for keeping stuff, anything. It's very, very common, simple basket.
I'm admiring the calligraphy in back of you. Could you tell us who wrote it and what it means?
Yes, this was done by our headmaster and founder, Mr. Sofu Teshigahara, when he came to United States in 1962. That was one of the first trip he made to United States. And he was kind enough to visit my house. And this house was right after built. And we bought it because of the view, which we could see the Golden Gate Bridge from our living room window. And that was evening time. We gathered about 15 people from my mother and our class students here in our living room. And had Japanese cuisine and viewed beautiful moonlight from the window. It says, Gekko Mado ni Mitsu. Moonlight filled the window. That's the large Japanese, Chinese character, and it's Showa 37, which is 1962, at the Uchida Kyoshitsu, Uchida Shunye Kyoshitsu, which is my mother's flower name, and signature is Sohu. So this is one of my treasure, which I most important and cherish item from Sofu Sensei. Most of the arrangement we make, Moribana flat base arrangement, we use green material and two or three flower or glass materials as a subordinate branches. However, this mazeike mixed arrangement, you combine more than five or six materials, And as I was saying, autumn, seven grasses is the most common, famous type of arrangement. And we even have a poem by saying all the autumn grasses. It's Susuki, Hagi, Kuzu, Nadeshiko, Ominaeshi, Fujibakama, Kikyo. Those are the materials. Some of them are bellflower and all the English name is too hard for me to say, but there is a poem including all the names of seven grasses. And as you can see, I'm cutting all the materials stem under the water, which is the mizugiri, which prolongs the life of the materials. It's very important. And there are many other methods, like burning the stem, crushing the stem, and using the alcohol or other chemical to hold the flowers longer. But mizugiri is the most common and simple way of keeping material fresh longer. My second arrangement is going to be a morimono.
I notice you have a variety of materials. How did you decide which materials to use and how to combine them?
One day I went to this groceries, which they carry very interesting and fresh materials in Berkeley. And I tried to choose the interesting shape of vegetables and fruits. I'm using cucumber, which is a very unusual shape. And also, I use dry okra. And now I'm using the grapes on the vine. And emphasize this grapes, rather than just putting flat I choose this container with a leg. And normally for morimono, I use a flat bamboo stand or a tray. Sometimes I use the palm leaves, but this is the first time I'm using tall Ikebana base for the morimono. As you can see, I'm using the colorful material like tomatoes and pepper and eggplant and this is squash, I think, and various shape of squash, and I also use the figs in the vase too, green figs, and this is radish to add the little color. It was fun to collect the various material in a different shape and also to place in a container like this. By the way, I'm not using any mechanic inside the container because of the shape of the vegetables and fruits. It stays very securely. And I think this type of arrangement can be seen from all over, all around arrangement. It's a finish now. Now I like to start my third arrangement, which is a modern arrangement, autumn arrangement.
The container you're using is very interesting. Is that ceramic or metal?
Yes, it's a metal container, which is made by headmaster's atelier. All the master teachers create the very interesting various shape of metal arrangement there. And it comes in various sizes, and it has a metal piece to go with. You can combine also. Today I'm just using this tube portion.
The Argentine pampas grass you're using, I'm used to seeing the pure white one, which is up in my area. Did you get this in your yard? Did you grow this pampas grass?
No, I got this at the flower market, but it's very common in East Bay too. And as you say, they come in various type. This is more like a light brown, pinkish color, but it comes in white. Also silver color, and it's really reminds me autumn. And in Japan, autumn arrangement, Suzuki is the most common material, which is a little scarce in Bay Area. but the pampas grass reminds me the autumn season very much.
What materials are you adding now?
That's a pink cushion. It comes in orange, almost red color, and this one happens to be the yellow one, orange color. And I'm using as a mass. I bunched about five pink cushions together, wire them to save the time.
Joan, what is that line material that you're using?
I'm sorry, I don't know the name of the glass, but it was I just found it in the field, and I thought line was interesting, and it has a very small soft leaves, and I stripped all the leaves and just kept the line to add the arrangement movement is very important for the soget's arrangement, mass, color, small. Those things we have to keep in mind when you make an arrangement, one of the important elements. For my final arrangement, I like to make a freestyle again. Since I'm going to place this arrangement in front of the vertical sculpture which I made, I'm emphasizing horizontal lines in this arrangement.
Joan, would you please tell us about the vases you are using?
This container is called model, window in English. It was designed by our founder and headmaster, Sofu Teshigahara, long ago. I have enjoyed using it for many years. It's a very enjoyable to use and comes in many colors, like yellow and white. you see here, black and red also. It's versatile too. You can use it horizontal like this, of course, but also vertically on its end too. I love it very much.
I believe that variegated material that you are using is a type of Dracaena. I have some at my house and it looks very, very similar. The bleached white material you're using, it looks like wheat, but is it wheat and where did you find it?
Yes, it's a bleached wheat and I got it at San Francisco Flower Mart.
I know you use some yellow chrysanthemums, but what are the other flowering materials you used?
I'm using different kinds of chrysanthemums because they remind us of the four seasons. It's a special flower to Japanese. The Emperor's crest is a chrysanthemum.
It's an amazing structure that you have behind your containers. Could you tell us what the tubes are made of and how the whole thing was put together?
I recycled old heavy cardboard tubes, glued them together and drilled to a wood and bamboo base for Soget's outdoor flower show in May. I'd like to thank President of Ikebana International, San Francisco Bay Area Chapter, Ms. Sharon Hurwitz, Chairperson for the day, Mr. Ron Brown, Program Committees, and also I'd like to thank our members who were kind enough to create a beautiful site arrangement for today's program. Lastly, I'd like to thank Ellen, my granddaughter, who videotaped and edited my demonstration. Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you, Mrs. Suzuki, for a wonderful demonstration. And thanks to our members who shared their arrangements. Our next program will be Friday, November 19th, and feature Mrs. Fusako Hoirup representing WAFU School. Please join us then. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
Bye.